hello everybody, it is I, Mesmo, and this time around I gonna explain a lot of things, including the concept of Minecraft Game Show Awards, and about a few more details inside of it. Not everything though, because there's gonna be a lot of things to discuss, and I will continue explaining stuff from 2 weeks, 2 weeks from today. But without further ado, let's go on what we will discuss today. These are the questions and things that I will talk to you about, which will be set in stone as of right now. I hold on to my words, but there's always a chance of small changes. The reason why I say small changes, because we will get to the tiers and I will kind of explain the reasoning behind the tiers and so on and so forth. Also, there might be extensions to the categories, but that will be another day to talk about. But for now, let's talk about Minecraft Game Show Awards and what is it about. Well, Minecraft Game Show Awards is a chance for a lot of game show content creator who would like to get more audience and share the audience with other people. So it's kind of like an exchange and grow on their own, and of course give a little bit of an extra chance, having a huge community, bringing the communities all together to, you know, for one simple reason: making more Minecraft game shows for everyone, or just playing them even. That's also a good thing to do. But this tries to bring up the chances of doing these more often in the future. Now, also, because this is kind of like Oscars, we will give out recognition to certain shows based on votes and judges' opinions, aka giving out awards. And also we are doing this because we want to have some fun all together as one big community. And of course, based on all of these, we can always learn new things on what to change, what to do in order to make the shows better, what to make the event even better. Of course, you are feel free to suggest things in the comment section below if you have any idea, or contact me via Discord. Moving onwards on what we do in the Minecraft Game Show Awards is we're gonna have interviews before the events, but of course we will think about getting some interviews inside the event as well for more popular channels, content creators, and maybe giving a shout out to a few new content creator who just started, but they have a great promise to create good content. Of course, there will be a lot of interaction because I will ask your opinion on the awards. For example, on certain categories, there will be a voting system where you guys will cast your vote, but I will go into that in the next time. Of course, there will be awards, which, you know, based on the categories, on best hosts, so on and so forth. And of course, there will be games to play from other game shows, aka there will be one or two, actually, scrap that, there will be 3 games during the event that you can play anytime when you are not called to the stage. So basically it's not gonna be as before in the previous season, or should I say previous year, where we had games in between the awards. This time around, while the awards are going on and you are not required to take part in it, or you don't want to watch it, you can play games in the theater somewhere hidden for you. Now, I did mention a lot of things about tiers and awards, so let's talk about how did it work actually. There were three tiers, aka the chicken, the blaze, and the dragon tier. Now, these three tiers had all the categories by themselves. So chicken tier competed only against themselves. Same goes for the blaze and for the dragon. So there weren't any competition in between. So, you know, chicken tier has a chance to win, and the dragon tier wouldn't take everything away. As you might have guessed, the chicken tier is the lowest tier. People who just started doing Minecraft game shows, or they already started doing it but they didn't really make it through the quality check. The blaze tier is where there's already a few subscribers, some popularity, like a few hundred subscribers, so on and so forth, and there's a decent amount of edit. And the dragon tier is where basically you hit the 1,000 amount of popularity and subscribers and so on and so forth, and of course your quality in buildings are decent-ish, and of course the editing is right there that attracts all the people to watch it more and more. Now, how it was determined was there was a few people called the judges who were telling their opinions, giving a score system, and based on the score system the game shows got their tier given. This time around it's gonna be different, but let's just say that as of it was back then, there was only three tiers, but all of the tiers had the same categories if there were enough applicants for that category. Now, moving on how will it work, is that there will be three tiers, but there will be three sub-tiers for each tier. So there will be a chicken minus, chicken neutral, aka zero, and chicken plus, same goes for blaze and dragon. Now the reason why I'm doing this is, depending on the amount of applicants, I might gonna do more tiers, but as of right now, I'm gonna stick with these three base tiers, and if there's like an overflow of applicants in one or two tiers, I'm gonna break them up into minus, zero, plus. Now, you will have the chance to choose your tier, although there will be at least a few requirements in order to pick the higher tier, or for more popular content creators, there will be a cap limit minimum on where they cannot go below. Let's go from the chicken tier. Chicken tier is the quite easiest thing. Everyone can compete except the exceptions from blaze and dragon tier people. So you can pretty much go there. If you don't have subscribers, that's not a problem. At least you have to have a few episodes of your show from this year published on any social media network. That can be YouTube or any other, like with me, any video based, oh right, Twitch even. It's a stream thing, but there's a stream award as well, so don't forget that. Now moving on with the minus zero pluses in chicken. You can choose either which you wanna be, but if you feel really powerful and you don't wanna go to Blaze just yet, you can still stick with the chicken plus. And that's pretty much it. It's quite explanatory on how you feel you are being competitive with the others. Of course, I do have to mention that if there aren't enough applicants for a certain sub tier, there will be merges. Like I will bring the minus with the neutral all together into one. And who knows, maybe the chicken plus will be a Blaze tier by itself. It really all comes down to you and everyone else who creates game shows and want to apply for the show. Now, for the Blaze category, same goes as the chicken, there's minus zero plus, but the requirement is that you should have at least a few hundred subscribers and some amount of editing in the video. So if you just record the entire thing and no cuts, or the intro is just a slideshow of the players, don't expect to be in the Blaze. Now, the minus is the lowest for the Blazes, like let's say 100 subscriber, and for the plus would be right near the thousands. So everything else is in between, and of course it's your choice on which sub tier you wanna choose. Of course, for people who have just a few hundred, still can choose chicken plus, but they are not allowed to choose the minus or the zero, because that would cause unfair advantage compared to others. Now, moving on with the higher and higher ranks, there is a warning I have to mention, because if you pick the highest possibility of tiers that you can choose from, it will be a less chance for you to win. So I'm gonna warn right now, do not be salty, I gave you enough heads up about choosing a higher tier. It comes with consequences, so don't be surprised if you don't win a category if you pick a very high tier that you could manage. And of course, there's the dragon tier. People who hit the 1000 marker or above can freely choose from these categories, although I do have to mention, whoever has 3000 or more subscribers, they are capped to choose only the Dragon Plus. Same reasoning as before, unfair advantage due to other players. Although I do have to mention that the number limit cap can change, considering there's a lot of Minecraft game shows with multiple subscribers, from thousands to 10,000 and hundreds, 100,000s. And all comes down to who applies for the show. It might change the numbers along the way. For instance, if there would be at least 5 to 10 people who has more than 100,000 subscribers for their show, it's gonna bring down or everyone else who has just 3 to 5 thousand to the neutral state. But chances are it's not gonna happen just yet. Although we are trying to reach out for multiple communities, it all comes down to everyone if they wanna take part in it or not. Now, that's out of the way. Oh, just one more thing with the Dragon Minus. Whoever has 1,000 or so amount of subscribers, and their quality is top-notch, though, they can still pick Blaze Plus. But they cannot go below that. Of course, as I said before, Dragon tier needs to be edited quite well. There should be some good buildings along the way, so on, so forth. And when you apply, which I will mention hopefully next time, but I'm just giving you a heads up again about this, is that whenever you apply, you can choose your tier, but you will be the one applying with a show you want to compete with in the Minecraft Game Show Awards. You can apply with multiple shows, of course, but that will also cause you split your audience with the voting. So it might be smart just to apply with one show, but maybe if you apply with multiple shows, that also gives you a chance to win multiple awards. It's totally up to you. Moving on with the awarding systems, there will be two types, vote-based and judge-based. Last year there were only voting-based, which was kind of unfair in multiple ways because some of the people had a lot of subscribers. Basically, it was in Dragon and Blaze tier where it was kind of OP for some people. That is why there's gonna be categories that are gonna be vote-based, and there will be categories that are judge-based. For example, fan favorite. That's definitely gonna be a vote-based category. So is for the best host. Or maybe not. We'll see. It's not set in stone yet. Although the judge-based, which I'm quite sure of, that will be a judge-based category, is the best game show in general, or best build even, because those are things that you shouldn't really rely on the viewership on voting, because of course they cannot vote for their favorite show regardless of the building quality. That is why there will be multiple people from multiple communities called judges who will give their score on each show. Of course, people who are came from a certain community who makes certain shows cannot vote in their own tier. Like, let's say if the community came from the Dragon tier show and they pretty much cannot vote for any Dragon tier categories. They can still vote on Blaze and Chicken, but nothing else. And all those scores will be added up, and the most scored game shows will be mentioned in the event. Same goes for the vote-based system categories, where whenever there's a voting, and this is something I wanted to mention. Every single game show will be available for vote. There's not gonna be any selection this time. So you can vote for one and only one show that you like from that certain category in one tier. Of course, you can vote for multiple tier game shows, but in one category per tier, you can only vote for one show. And the top four voted game shows will be mentioned in the event as being called the nominees. Everyone else, well, that's sad, but they're not gonna be mentioned. Maybe some sort of highlight on who did apply for the show afterwards, like in an aftermath. Other than that, that's pretty much it that I wanted to talk about the award system. If I ever miss out anything about the Minecraft Game Show Awards, I will talk about it in an upcoming update video. Now, for finally, the eventual. I will be updating Minecraft Game Show Awards every 2 weeks. I will definitely make one video to update the situation. What I can definitely promise you is that in the next update video, I will tell you guys about the categories on what you can apply for and how to apply for the show. And from that day, you guys can pretty much start the application sending in to me. Until then, figure out what you wanna do, what kind of game show you wanna apply with, so on and so forth. And of course, I will explain on what requirements you need to do to make in order to apply your show for Minecraft Game Show Awards. And the application section, starting from 10th of June, which is 2 weeks from now when I upload this video, will be all along until 13th of September. So whenever we hit the last day, and it's gonna be midnight for GMT plus 2, aka Central Europe time, the application will be closed. And after that, a week or so, hopefully on 7th of October, all the applications will be processed and people will be able to vote for each category and tier of game shows until the 11th of November. Of course, I do have to mention in the vote section, or should I say even before the vote section, there will be a demo reel, or should I say trailers for each show in the line on who did what and in what quality. So before you vote, you definitely should look at those videos in order to make a very good decision. Oh, and not to mention, there's not gonna be any more I don't know my vote just yet thing, so you definitely have to vote for someone at least. Not to mention, whenever you vote for a certain category, I do have to mention that you need to explain your reasoning, and don't worry, it's not gonna be just one voting Google Doc, there will be multiple ones for each category. So like, for Dragon Tier, best build voting system, there will be a Chicken, Blaze, and Dragon, or maybe more tiers depending on the applicant amount, but yeah, you get the point. For each category, there will be one Google Doc to vote on. And of course, once those numbers have been processed after 11th of November, 2 weeks from then, the Minecraft Game Show Awards event will be held on that day. A more specific time on when exactly will the event be held will be told in one of the upcoming update videos, but it's not gonna be in the next one, probably around 2 or 3 updates before the actual event. Next time I will definitely talk about about how to apply and about the categories on what you can apply for. But until then, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Toodaloo!